Moreover, for small island developing states like Mauritius, blockchain represents an opportunity to accelerate development in line with the SDGs as well. In the field of development, aid for instance, the resilience and transparency of blockchain-based systems can help agencies assess, improve, and scale aid models, reassure donors, and make receiving aid easier. It provides unprecedented levels of accountability through smart contracts that automate service transactions without the need for inefficient or costly intermediaries. Blockchain can also provide solutions for money transfers that are secure, efficient, and scalable. Remittances are intrinsic to the development of emerging economies, especially with the input of the diaspora. From the service user's perspective, such solutions that can be accessed via smartphone give unbanked and simply remote population access to basic but essential financial services, saving them time as well as money. Another area is energy management, where blockchain-based technologies can build on the success of small green energy producers by further promoting transparency, building trust, and encouraging collaboration within different parties in local communities. It can also connect citizens and communities and encourage sustainable local community growth. In this new model, community members produce their own renewable energy and incentivize each other to purchase any excess production, thus creating a local market. We need blockchain to create these micro communities, which make it easier to monitor targeted communal infrastructural and social development in the country. These monitoring and planning tools may include the use of blockchain technology to prevent waste and fraud on government spending for a project, or the use of national interactive development map to anticipate which sector require institutional support. On the community side, a micro community will have numerous benefits in terms of job creation, investment, the creation of complementary industries, or enhancing productivity and efficiency through collaborative development. There are, of course, many other branches where blockchain application can result in significant economic and social gains in a reasonably short time frame. Ladies and gentlemen, Mauritius has since early on understood the potential of blockchain as a mechanism for change. The Board of Investment, now known as the Economic Development Board, which is a partner of my ministry for this conference, had as far back as September 2016 organized a seminar to demystify blockchain and explore opportunities for its application for both private and public sector initiatives. The seminar brought together facilitated renowned speakers from Stratton, Wiskin, and Centre National de la Recherche Scientifique de Paris, among many others. The buzz around the technology was created, and it became clear that Mauritius can play a big role in becoming a blockchain hub for the region, as well as improving this process, be it in private companies or for government, by adopting new technology. For this to happen, increased collaboration with startups, which can develop applications based on blockchain, as well as the implementation of the technology at government level for carefully selected projects are being prioritized. Ladies and gentlemen, my ministry recently awarded a contract for the preparation of a strategic plan for the adoption of blockchain technology in government. The consultants are required to ensure that the strategic plan is in line with the vision, mission, and objective of the government of Mauritius. The strategic plan should also provide an assessment of existing government system and non-computerized important activities where blockchain would have high value addition, setting out the approach and solutions which need to be adopted to reach the desired goals. And finally, to ensure fast rollout of blockchain technology in government, the consultants will be required to provide the technical specification for the ministry to tender out to e-government projects on the technology. Dear participants, we need to be constantly at the forefront of innovation and aspire to become leaders of this new innovation. that we humans have created wittingly or by the course of history. This cannot be one. This event is one such bridge. The brightest minds cannot succeed on their own, and the deepest pockets cannot alone develop new ideas. Collaboration between developers, academia, and government is a sine qua non, and platforms are necessary for all of them to be discussed and generate new ideas and projects. I'm certain that this summit will result in fruitful outcomes for everyone involved. I wish you all a pleasant stay, Mauritius. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. I request you to kindly remain on stage. I request Muhammad Saleem to come on stage and present him a small memento. It's a pleasure to have you, Honorable Minister.
Can you get that?
Thank you very much.